Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Friday, February 5th, 2010. Not a lot of surprises from Thursday's trading. The one major surprise was that the S&P 500 came down and closed below last week's low. The TSX is still holding last week's low. Venture Exchange certainly broke through it. Materials are trading right at it. Energy stocks have not got down that far yet. Financial stocks are still holding last week's lows. And gold stocks closed below last week's low, indicating lower prices. So we'll watch the TSX to see if it can hold last week's lows on Friday. Looking at the Canadian dollar, we traded below last week's lows and closed there. For crude oil, we certainly had a huge reversal day yesterday after being up a couple of days and giving us a daily buy signal for crude oil. Big move down yesterday. Similar move for gold. Now, a couple of days ago, we showed you how bearish the grains were, corn, soybeans, wheat, and they look pretty similar to what copper is doing right now. Now, copper is different than crude oil and gold. Copper does not have the retail coverage, the retail focus that crude oil and gold has. There's no ETFs really. There's not a lot of retail people, investing in copper, and it's not certainly a glamour metal. The only time you buy copper is because you're going to build something, and it's known as the economic barometer of the world if you watch copper prices. And they have certainly been breaking down for the last couple of weeks and have been down sharply the last couple of days, and that is very bearish for the global economic outlook. Looking at the U.S. dollar is still doing very well. It closed above 80 yesterday, and we're looking for a move up to 81.25 as our next target to the upside. Looking at our Horizon Beta Pro bear ETFs, some of them got down to test the lower channel line over the last couple of days, but now they're all back on track. Energy, financials, the gold one was up sharply yesterday, and the bear for the TSX 60 was up sharply as we are looking for the TSX to break down below last week's low. We're looking for the Horizon Beta Pro Bear ETF for the TS60 to break out above last week's high. Looking at the 60-minute charts for Friday morning, we can remain bearish on the TSX as long as we don't start closing above 11,280. We can remain bearish on energy stocks as long as we don't start closing above 280-250 on an hourly basis. We can remain bearish on financial stocks as long as we don't start closing above 169 on an hourly basis. We're still waiting for some confirmation whether we're going higher or lower on the financial stocks. We've been trading sideways for weeks. We've been trading between two lines. We have some lows back here, and we're going to look to see if we can break down below those lows on Friday. Otherwise, this two-line range is still in play. And last but not least this morning, we can remain bearish on gold stocks on Friday as long as we don't start closing above 307 on the TSX Gold Index on an hourly basis. Okay, that's all for Friday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Monday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit TheUptrend.com.